in the book of Haggai. Don't turn there, just listen. I'm only going to read one verse. In the book of Haggai, chapter 1, there is a point in the life of Israel where it is time to be about the rebuilding of the temple. And the temple was an image of the presence of God. And Haggai comes to preach a series of sermons to tell the people it is time. In Haggai chapter 1, verse 2, he says this. This kind of begins his series of sermons. Thus speaks the Lord of hosts, saying, this people says, the time has not come, the time that the Lord's house should be built. Then the word of the Lord came by Haggai the prophet, saying, it is time. Is it time for you yourselves to dwell in your paneled houses and this temple to lie in ruins? Now therefore, says the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. It is in that introduction that Haggai begins and declares and calls God's people to a reminder of the vision that was ahead for his people. In this particular case, it was a vision for what was ahead to be built. To some degree, I want to do that this morning. I certainly don't claim to be Haggai. But as we gather on a Sunday, much like ones we meet for each year, usually it's the second, third, fourth Sunday in January, it depends, and look back a little bit and look ahead, this morning, I want to take just a few minutes to talk about what Pastor Brian and Pastor Micah and I have gathered together, and we're kind of calling it Vision 2017. Vision 2017. It's a very specific vision. Am I on? Oh, the back screen's not. Oh, there we go. I want to start kind of at the beginning for me. This April will be 12 years since my family and I came on board to be the senior pastor. For me to be the senior pastor at Green Acres Baptist Church. And when I came on board here, I shared with you, with this fellowship, and many of you weren't here then, and you've come since then, and I shared with the pastor search team that based on prayerfully looking, God put on my heart five major priorities as we came on board at Green Acres. The five priorities were, number one, prayer. We have done a number of things related to that. We've continued a men's prayer meeting that's been going on for decades now. We've established a ladies' prayer meeting just recently. Our Wednesday nights for the last 6 or 7 years, we've done nothing but study prayer and pray. And so I believe we've continued to point people toward the priority of prayer. The next priority I said in that day was outreach. And in that we've added our Grow ministry, which is now going on its 12th year. This August will be 12 years we've been doing Grow outreach teams have been critical. Our family Grow nights in the summer, four of those Sundays are nothing but outreach and witness. We've shifted our transportation outreach around so that it becomes more kind of outward focused. We pick up on Sunday afternoons now for Awana. We pick up a lot of kids' outreach. I could go on and on about the outreach that we've built and strengthened and refocused. Another one of those priorities as I came in 12 years ago was fellowship. There are a number of things we've done related to fellowship, none the least of which also involves our family Grow nights in the summer, involves our events throughout the year to bring people together and just be together in fellowship around God and around His Word. And then another priority almost 12 years ago that I share was leadership. And I could go through all the things we've done and established and reemphasized and trained to strengthen leadership from our pastoral staff to our deacon body to our ministry heads to our committee, the way they function, and on and on. And there was one more priority that I shared almost 12 years ago. That was renovation. And renovation was not only about us spiritually, but it was something more specific even about us physically. I want to spend some time kind of focusing in on that last priority over the next little while. Renovation. One of the things we determined when I came on board here was that we believe God was having us to stay at Green Acres Baptist Church in this location, 901 Alberta Road. There had been a lot of changes through the years, and the church had experienced some real decline and transitions, and we were trying to determine, God, what's next for us? Is it right here, or is it in another location? We were open to either, and we determined right off the bat very quickly that we believe God had us to stay here. And while in that day, I remember us talking about it, and I've talked about it since then, buildings are not the church. If all these burned down today, all this campus burned down today, we'd still have Green Acres Baptist Church. So buildings are not the church, but we also determined that buildings that are falling apart don't necessarily in and of themselves glorify God. So we began to look at different ways we could upgrade and change and basically state to our community, we're here and we're not just here, but we are planning on being here for a long time. We're going to flourish. And so there are a lot of small projects that we did from the Rock, which is the youth worship center. It has since been renovated even again. Our kids' place, which is our children's worship center. You've got the Rock, that is the youth worship center. Kids' place, that's children, which I think sometime years ago began to be called the Pebble, since you've got the Rock for youth. And Pastor Mike, I don't know if you know this, but some of our children have been meeting together to talk about calling this the Boulder that we're in right now. So I don't know if that'll happen, but anyway, it made sense to them. But there are a number of other renovation and change jobs we did, the largest of which is where we're sitting right now. It was a complete renovation and reconstruction of the sanctuary and immediate surroundings. Now, for those who may not have been here 8 years ago when we moved in here, this sanctuary was originally built in 1976, or at least it was first used in 1976 for the first time. And when I came in 2005, other than a few little quick tweaks, there had been really no renovations, no real major upgrades to what was moving into a 30-year-old facility. And so we had some major troubles with it, some major problems that need to be renovated. And the more we looked at it, we said, well, do we change carpet? Do we do just a new roof? And the more we looked at it, we said, really, if we're going to do all those things, we might want to look at a complete renovation and reconstruction, which we did. And in October of 2008, a project that took about 18 months, we worshiped in the gym for 18 months. Many of you remember that. Some of you who are maybe new to Green Acres don't recall that, but we met down in the gymnasium for 18 months, and this sanctuary was renovated. All that foyer area was added. We added on about 13,000 square feet. And so in all that, one of the things we were challenged with was this, which is always the challenge, cost, right? They don't build these things for free. And so as we looked at it, we said, we looked at a number of factors, none the least of which was looking at the last 10 years up to that point. The previous 10 years, construction costs had risen 8 to 10% a year for almost 10 years consecutive. And we looked at that and said, well, if we wait even 3 to 4 years, if the trend just continues, and even if it's conservative, 4 to 5% a year, we were looking at how much more it would cost. And so we decided to go ahead and press forward and do this project. And the final tally was somewhere around $3.6 to $3.7 million that the entire project cost. New lighting, new facility. The only thing that's the same in this building are these walls and these windows. We had to renovate our entire TV studio that many of you don't even know is there. It's upstairs, a TV production studio for a TV ministry, our sound, our lighting, our lighting board. We totally renovated the baptistry area, the choir area. This entire stage platform area was redone and expanded, and on and on and on it went. And so this was the final cost. So with much prayer and fasting and thought, we hesitantly but believed it was the Lord's leading for us to move forward in this cost, but because of the cost, there was a large portion of it that we were required to finance. So when it was all said and done, we financed about $3.3 million of it 8 years ago. We financed it through Wachovia Bank. We originally talked with the North American Mission Board, which had a church finance division, and all the interest would go back into missions. We were able to lock in through Wachovia with the goal of eventually financing through the North American Mission Board. Since then, they've stopped doing that, by the way. North American Mission Board no longer has a church finance piece. In the last 8 years, with a varying interest rate that we had to refinance every year or two, or sometimes 3 years, so several times we've had to kind of re-lock in, which cost us closing costs and all that. Not to mention the fact that for this area, we had to replace a $75,000 heating and air system. When we renovated, it was still working fine, so we didn't change it then. 5 years later, it went out. We replaced that. But in these last 8 years, we've been able to go from a $3.3 million note to a note that is now stands at about $1.67 million. That means we have, over 8 years, eliminated about $1.63 million. We've cut it in half. Now, I know for our guests, you may think, well, here I'm a guest for the first time, and the church is talking about money, right? I get it. I got it. I know what's going on. If you have any doubts about us, you're welcome to go to our website and check out my messages for the last umpteen numbers of weeks and see how we roll. That having been said, I believe it's important as a pastor from time to time to share what's going on very clearly. We do monthly finance sheets, and we do updates on our expenses and our finances and our yearly budget and all those things we do, and we try to be very transparent. But every once in a while, I just believe it's necessary to communicate some of these things so that the people who are part of Green Acres will know. So if you're our guest, hopefully this is encouragement to you and not a burden on you as we go. Some weeks ago, we approached a particular organization. Actually, they approached us, an organization that does church, primarily church financing. They are an organization that the North American Mission Board now uses, although it's not a part of NAMB. It is an entity in and of itself. And we approached them to talk to them about possibly refinancing. We've had not a great interest rate, decent through the years, and we look to try to reduce that interest rate to try to expedite the elimination of this note we have. And it didn't really work out with that organization, so Pastor Brian and Pastor Mike and I just began to pray. And right about the time we finished talking to that other organization, one day a gentleman stopped by. And he was from BB&T Bank locally, and he said, "My name is Sam, and I am a loan officer with BB&T. I primarily do bank loan or church financing. So I would like to talk to you if you all have any financing needs. I don't know, but I'd like to talk to you about them if you have need," and left his card. And so we followed up and said, "Sure, we'll talk to him." And as we began to talk to him, we began to see that I think this thing is going to begin to work out. In fact, we were able to talk to Sam. We were to be able to get approved through BB&T to refinance a note that will be partially variable, partially fixed. All that to say, our interest rate over the years has been 5%. It's actually going to be come down very, very soon to about 3.9%. Without getting into a lot of the details, you're welcome to stop by the office if you want more information. We're very transparent on this. But what we realized is that refinancing this way was going to take us, was going to begin to save us somewhere between $4,000 and $5,000 a month on our monthly payment on this note. And so Pastor Micah and Pastor Brian and I began to pray, and we said, "You know what? We've got a real possibility here to do something that could advance us forward in ministry in very significant ways." Out of that, kind of established what we're calling Vision 2017. Vision 2017. Now, Vision 2017 is a very specific vision. It doesn't change the fact that our primary mission is to worship God, exalt Him, win the lost, and equip the saved. It doesn't change the fact that the vision of Green Acres Baptist Church overall, the mission is to worship and win and equip. The vision is that God is building a church both numerically and spiritually. He's growing a church both numerically and spiritually of a variety of cultures and races and backgrounds and socioeconomic levels. That's our vision. But we have kind of a very specific vision going into 2017 that I want to share with you right now. For now, each month, our monthly minimum payment toward the note that we have is $16,260 a month. You say, that's a lot of money. You better believe it is. It is. It is a lot of money. That's what we pay minimum each month. Now, over these past 8 years, we've made a bunch of extra payments on the note. There were several years where at the end of the year, we were putting $100,000 a year back on the principal of the note. And so we've done far more than just pay this minimum over the 8 years that we've gotten to this place. That's how we got $1.63 million paid off up to this point. That's the monthly cost. Annually, as we go in each year, our cost, just the minimum cost for the note, is about $195,100. That's the $16,260 a month times 12. This is about how much we pay out each year just in that minimum payment. Now, we always pay more than that minimum, but I'm just saying that's minimum. So I have a very, very important question for you this morning. What possible expansions could we make of ministries of worship, discipleship, and outreach with an additional $195,100 each year? How could we expand our worship? How could we expand our discipleship? How could we expand our outreach? How could we expand in our community? How could we expand where our staff is concerned to be able to organize and arrange and lead out and more? How could we expand in everything from the orphanage, the Hopewell House in Belize, to other ministries and missions, from Fellowship of Christian Athletes that we support, to missionaries we support in South Africa, the cooperative program giving that we do as a Southern Baptist Church, local association, our CSM, on and on and on we go. Our transportation ministry, what could we do with that? What could we do in our children's ministry, you know, with that, reaching children? What could we do in our student ministry with another $195,000 a year? What could we do with even greater needs in terms of upgrades and maintenance and all these things with our facilities? That doesn't even begin to get in what I've already mentioned: community missions, foreign missions, leadership, and the idea goes on. So that is where we come back to what I referred to earlier, Vision 2017. Vision 2017, in short, is very simple. It is our effort to eliminate this final amount we have on this note within the next 5 to 6 years. You say, well, Pastor Johnny, why is it Vision 2017? Because this is the year we're launching out. Our goal is to eliminate that note by the time we come to Vision Sunday 2023, that it'll be gone. Maybe before then, but at least within the next 5 to 6 years, that's our goal. I believe God may be very gracious and help us to eliminate it before that. But what if within the next 5 years, we're able then to look out and say, okay, Lord, what do you want us to do with an extra $16,000 a month relative to ministry? We believe, we meaning at this point, Pastor Micah, Pastor Brian, and I, as we've prayed together and thought together and sought together, we believe it is very, very reasonable to think that we can eliminate this remaining $1.67 million in the next 5 to 6 years. It's something God's put on our hearts, and it's not just a pipe dream. It is an idea that we have, I guess you'd call kind of a four-step plan, if you will. The first step is what I've already shared with you, to refinance the bank note. You say, why is that a big deal? For those who understand mortgages, you'll understand. If we can eliminate If we can go down from about 5% to about 3.9%, it saves us somewhere between $4,500 and $5,000 a month. And what if we took that entire $4,500 to $5,000 a month and put it back on the principal every month? Not use it somewhere else. Put it back on the principal of that note every month. For those who understand mortgages, you get it, how quickly that would whittle down that note. And so the first step we're talking about is this refinance, which is in the process of happening. The second step is really what I just shared. It's paying the monthly savings we have on that refinance back on the note's principal to accelerate the elimination of that note. The third step, we actually have a significant sum currently in our building fund. I think we have about $250,000 currently in our building fund. So another step would be immediately begin to use not all that. We leave some of it in for emergency, but we begin to put some of that, even we have right now, on the principal. Again, the quicker you put money on the principal, the less time you have for interest to build on that principal, if you understand kind of the way mortgages work. So that's number three. Number four, well, that's where we all come in. Number four, in the next however many years it takes us, all offerings designated for the building fund, we will apply those back on the principal of this note. All offerings that come in for the building fund will be applied back on this building note to continue to eliminate and whittle down that principal. Now listen, each of us as part of Green Acres Baptist Church should have a monthly or weekly offering that we give depending on when you, or some of you are paid twice a month. Maybe you give monthly, maybe you give twice a month, maybe you give weekly. I don't know how it is you give, but you have a regular offering that you give. And whatever percentage of your income that is that God's put on your heart, you give that. What we're talking about this morning is prayerfully saying, Lord, over and above what I'm already giving, Lord, could you lead me to give an extra 5%, an extra 10%, or more? Whatever the Lord puts on your heart. Lord, I want to continue to give what I'm giving to the budget. By the way, Our annual budget is somewhere in the neighborhood of $804,000. Well, it's not in the neighborhood of that. It is that. $804,942. That's annually. That stands up to about $15,479 a week. And so the money you give regularly goes to this budget. It pays for missions. It pays for ministry. It pays for electricity. It pays for staff expenses. It pays for outreach. It pays for vans that pick up children. It pays for materials. It pays for books, on and on and on. Anything we do in this church body relative to ministry, that budget helps to pay. Now, so what I'm asking and what I'm sharing is not that you would take a portion of your regular offerings and designate that toward the building fund, but that you would prayerfully say, Lord, I'm already giving this offering weekly or monthly, but Lord, would you have me give a portion above and beyond that toward this need? Now, folks, here's the thing. I've been here for almost 12 years, and you know me and you know my heart, I believe, for those who have known me for any length of time. My heart is not primarily about finances, but it is primarily about what God's doing in this fellowship. So having been here the amount of time I have, let me just kind of shoot it straight. Some of you sitting there today, right now, you could write a check for $10,000. Some of you here today, you say, Pastor, I can only give $10 extra a month, and so be it. If that's what God's enabled you, allowed you to give, so be it. Maybe some of you could give an extra $100 a month. Maybe some more than that. Some of you could give a one-time offering. Some of you could give a monthly offering till we get this done. Some of you say, well, Pastor, I can give this much once a quarter over and above my regular giving. Look, I'm not here to tell you what God's telling you to give. All I'm saying is this is the vision as we look at it. Say, if we can eliminate this amount that we're paying out, what would it allow us to do in these coming years? Here are some ways, just prayerfully, that you might be able to give. Number one, maybe a special weekly offering. Over the next couple of weeks, within the next couple of weeks, you're going to receive a letter. If you're a member of Green Acres or part of Green Acres, you'll receive a letter that kind of condenses what I'm sharing here. And you're going to receive that letter, and it's going to have some envelope in it. And it's going to be an envelope that just says Vision 2017 on it. And you're going to have an opportunity to take, and as you give extra offerings, maybe weekly, maybe monthly, we would ask that you would use that envelope. Or maybe you do your offering like I do. I kind of set mine up to go straight from the bank to the church that comes here. Maybe you set it up that way and you mark it Vision 2017 on that if you're giving. If you're giving electronically through the website or through our app, you give that extra offering, you mark it Vision 2017. There are some who could give one-time gifts. Maybe you have an amount you could give, and you say, I really can't give monthly, but I have an amount right now that I can give. You can do that. Maybe you have some kind of property, a vehicle, jewelry, a piece of property, whatever. And God leads you to say, you know what, I can give this, or I can sell this and give it, or I can give it to the church who can then turn around and cash in it, whatever the case might be to give for this. Then there's what I might call creative fundraising. We're not going to do 127 yard sales or chicken sales or whatever here at Green Acres, but maybe the Lord puts it on your heart saying, honey, we got to get rid of a bunch of stuff. Let's have a yard sale. And whatever we raise in it, let's just put that toward Vision 2017 as we go. Those are some of the ways that you can give. So here's the bottom line. This is Vision 2017. We're not going to do a big capital fundraising program. This is it. What I'm telling you here, this is the capital fundraising right here. I'm asking you to pray, and we'll send something out in a couple of weeks as a reminder and as a help and information and those who couldn't be here. This message will actually be on our website that they can go back and check out if they have questions about it. I'm just exhorting this fellowship that together we would be debt-free from that note within the next 5 to 6 years, which would enable us to expand our ministries in ways that who knows what God may do. I don't know what God has ahead. I know that God's there, and I know that God has our future. But I just believe, as I've said before, as great of things as God's done in our past, our latter can be greater than our former. Just a few moments, I'm going to pray. I'm going to ask you to do this. I feel like I would be amiss If I left here without giving you an opportunity, if God's speaking to your heart, to respond. Maybe you say, Pastor Johnny, when should this begin? As far as I'm concerned, you can begin giving today. As you leave today, our regular offerings you can drop in the offering plates in the as you leave. If you have a special offering, we don't have any Vision 2017 envelopes out. You can take a love offering envelope, write Vision 2017, drop it in there. Or maybe God has brought you this way, and as a guest, you're saying, you know what, I'm kind of excited to see what God has done and what God's doing in this church body, and maybe God's bringing me to be a part of this fellowship. And maybe today's your day to come. You know what, maybe in spite of all that I've shared, you say, Pastor, you haven't really shared the gospel. Know this, a lot of what I'm sharing here about eliminating this debt is about being able to multiply and get the gospel out even more effectively as the Lord leads. But maybe you're here today and you need to know the gospel. You need to know that Jesus Christ is your Savior. You can't really enter into what we're doing here because you've never trusted Christ as your Savior. I'm going to pray and I'm going to give you a few moments. It's not going to be long. And then when we're done, I'll pray and close us out and we'll head into our ministry fair. But I want to make sure and give an opportunity as the Lord speaks to any of your hearts that you might respond. Pray with me. Father, right now, help us to respond to whatever you've spoken to our hearts in Jesus' name. Why don't you stand right where you are?